I know, I know. Guess what? Guess what? Guess what? My baby daddy really is here today. Mark Consuelos, everybody.
Do you say that a lot?
I do. I sometimes say it when Anderson's here, like, yeah, as a joke. I'm like, my baby daddy. And everybody gets a big laugh. But it's actually true. You are.
I am.
Yeah. You are the father of our children.
Oh, thank you for saying that.
Yeah, you're welcome. You're welcome. You're welcome. I'm so excited. I'm so excited that you're here today. I'm so excited for tonight, for the premiere of your new show.
I'm so excited. Yeah. You know, I've been lucky enough to do some really cool projects over the past few years.
Yeah.
And each one I say, this is my favorite one. Remember, this is my favorite one. I kind of think this is my favorite one.
It's my favorite one.
It's my favorite. It's a show called Pitch. It's written by Dan Fogelman and Rick Singer. It's about the first female Major League Baseball player.
Yeah.
Which is amazing.
Yeah.
MLB is our partner. Major League Baseball is our partner in the show, which is fantastic. So we get to wear all the cool logos. I play the GM, which is, I play an ex-ball player, because now I'm at the age where I play ex-athletes.
Right. Remember when we first met and you used to play athletes?
I know. Yeah, I used to play athletes.
Now he plays ex-athletes.
Now I play, and I'm really psyched about that, because I get to wear cool suits, and I don't have to wear, like, the goofy baseball uniform, because after a certain age, guys shouldn't wear uniforms.
Right. Okay, good.
You know what I mean?
Yeah. Did you talk to MLB about that?
Well, no, because the GM wears a suit.
You know, I was telling people that you are on a show with the first female pitcher in the NBA. And people were like, okay. Because that's basketball.
That is basketball.
But I didn't understand, you know, I didn't get it. Now I get it.
But
you
saw the pilot. It's directed by the fantastic Paris Barclay. He's amazing.
So good.
Kevin Falls is our showrunner. The cast, Ali Larder, Jersey Girl.
Jersey Ali. Yeah. Oh my gosh, this girl, I love her so
Mark
much.
Mark Paul Gosselaar, Mo McRae, Tim Joe, Megan Holder.
Tell the audience, because you
last
had,
night?
No, you had all of these funny.
How about my Freudian slip last night?
Oh yeah. Oh my gosh.
But the pitcher is played by this wonderful actress named Kylie Bunbury. She's amazing.
She's amazing.
And they're asking me about her, and I'm like, and I said last night.
This is what he says out loud in front of me.
I mean, she's amazing. You can't keep your hands off of her. And I meant to say, you can't keep your eyes off of her.
But he said hands. He said hands.
I said that out loud.
I was like, well, you better try. Funniest thing ever. No, I was gonna say that you and how they, wherever you guys go, wherever the cast goes, they have Mark Paul Gosselaar, and now they've changed Mark's name to Mark Paul Consuelos. They just have added a Paul to your name.
We go to a press event, and they'll give us a little placard, and sometimes he's Mark Paul Consuelos, or I'm typically Mark Paul Gosselaar.
You're Mark Paul.
I like it. I like a middle name.
I like it too.
I like it. Are you glad to have me home? I've been gone for a few weeks.
It's an adjustment. I'm not gonna lie. I was very excited to see you when you came home yesterday. That was a nice surprise.
It was.
That was a nice surprise.
I did surprise you when I came home. I'm here.
Daddy's home.
I gotta tell you, I like living in Los Angeles a little bit.
Okay, is there something you want to announce?
No. It's really nice. I think a cloud one day.
In all the time you've been gone?
In the whole summer that I've been gone.
Wow.
It's pretty cool.
Yeah. It's pretty cool having you gone, I have to say.
Tell me about it.
We're doing all sorts of things. Like, the kids have moved into our room.
Right.
So I don't know if you know that. We now are all living in our bed.
Yes, like carnival people.
Like carnival people.
Yeah.
Right. And
nothing against carnival people.
Yeah, no. Sometimes we eat in the bed. Like, we'll have snacks on movie night.
That's horrible.
Yeah, I know. We're breaking all sorts of rules.
And?
We are breaking your rules like crazy.
Are you, like, touching things? He said, don't touch that. I can touch that.
Oh,
I can eat.
The kids have friends over every day.
Good.
They're playing video games. It's really crazy. It's like
I don't let the kids not have. Oh, the kids don't want to come over because
they don't want to come over
because
dad's
the mean dad's there.
Yeah, mean dad. Yeah. means your dad makes us pick up our toys afterwards. You know, that kind of stuff. So we have play dates constantly now.
Awesome.
It's like.
Well, I have play dates too, constantly.
I know.
No, I'm by myself. I walk around lonely. I got locked out of the house the other day.
In his underpants. It's an amazing story.
No, I was dressed and.
He FaceTimed me.
I'm like, all right, so I'm locked out. The wind closed. I was on this little balcony. The door shut. It closed. And I didn't know what to do. And I called Uber.
That makes perfect
sense. Perfect sense. I'm just gonna like call Uber because they'll figure it out. Like, what are they gonna do? Bring me my keys? I got Uber X. Come on, let's have a party.
No, but how did you wind up getting in?
I was so embarrassed. I called the it's a rental, so the person who's managing the rental property, I called and they came and then I did it again. Did it twice. I mean, I'm pretty useless by myself.
I know.
Useless. So you guys are having like a party and I'm like,
you're,
you know,
suffering.
I'm
so
suffering.
Much.
I'm suffering.
In your house with your one cloud. I do miss you terribly.
Oh,
you should
thank
know that.
You.
I do. Yeah. I put up a good front. But I do miss you terribly.
Yeah.
I like
it's not what I hear, but it's
no,
fine.
I forget how useful you are in my life for so many reasons.
Tell me.
I don't just mean like I love you and I enjoy our time together.
Uh-huh.
There's no lights in the house work. I cannot get the temperature.
That's me. I'm turning stuff off.
He does.
I turn stuff off, so you'll miss me.
He has a thing on his phone.
An app.
On his phone that allows him to control me from afar. So all of a sudden, I will wake up in the middle of the night, and I'm like, it's freezing in here.
Well, because I'm thinking, you know what, 76, I'm not there, but that's a little too humid for me. I need to turn it down, even though I just want to make sure that it's that the house is
so I'm right, well preserved.
Well preserved.
Right. I do miss you, but I'm happy to see you.
Thank you. Hey, traffic is insane in the city. The UN's in town.
The UN is in town.
Okay. I got out of the car yesterday. We were pointing the wrong direction. We couldn't make a left to head back uptown. I said to my driver, you know what? Go with God. I'll see you later. I was 30 blocks away. I walked home.
Yeah.
Excuse me,
I picked you up.
That's true.
That's okay. You didn't walk home. I was like, okay, you're leaving out a part of the story. I picked you up on the way home.
Oh, are we now the accuracy police here on, okay, all right, okay. I'm gonna embellish this funny story.
We can.
But now, let's be the accuracy police. I heard you didn't shave your legs yesterday, and you absolutely shaved your legs.
I heard about that.
People are texting me. She didn't shave her legs. Guess what? They were very shaved at 5:30 in the morning when I came home.
I know, because I got up and shaved them when I heard you were coming home.
Okay.
A little birdie told me you got on an earlier flight.
The birdie was me. Let's be accurate. Let's be accurate. The birdie was me.
You don't want
Let's
me
keep
to,
going. Okay. Let's keep going.
Do you want me to tell them about what else you do with
Bring
that phone?
Bring it on. Bring it on. No.
Okay, because I can. He does things with the phone that aren't right and
Listen,
should not be discussed.
I want to talk to you about something.
Okay.
There's the science of why we buy clothes that we never wear.
Oh my gosh.
I want to talk to you about that because, you know.
I'm the queen.
You will buy something and then you'll talk about how, okay, it's X amount, which is never too expensive because you're very sensible. But you'll say, just think about it. If I wear it 150 times, it's only going to be
$3. Yeah. That is, if I buy a pricey item, because we came from actor backgrounds together, so we've always been very mindful of every job could be your last job, right? So we plan for the future that way.
Yeah.
And so when I would buy something expensive, he's like, well, that's really expensive. And I'm like, yeah, but I've worn it 700 times. So price per wear, it's now paying me to wear it.
So people will ignore a major flaw if it's on sale.
Yes, that's true. I've done that.
Yeah, like I won't, I mean.
I will ignore a lipstick stain because it's 97%.
So that's one. We purchase for fantasy, not reality. So when we purchase stuff, we visualize ourselves wearing it. Right? I'm gonna look amazing in that. And then it's not. The reality is, I'm still 5'8", and it's not gonna look good on me. You know what I mean?
5'9".
Wait, 5'9", by the way. Let's be accurate.
Excuse me.
I just cut an inch off myself.
I would say you added an inch to yourself.
I need tape measure. We're gonna get a tape measure during commercial break.
Oh, these men.
During commercial break.
Always adding inches here and there.
All right.
right.
You do, yes, yes, yes. We know about your shoe size. We know.
Third,
we
size
know.
11.
We
third.
Know.
Big hands.
Third
thing is we love the item too much. Like, you'll buy something, but you won't wear it because you love it.
I'm too afraid to wear it because I love it so much. Yeah.
I've heard that come out of your mouth. You've actually said that out loud.
He's like, why don't you wear that new jacket? I'm like, I could never wear this. I love it so much. This is just a display.
We go shopping while tipsy. That's another reason. And do you remember?
Yes.
Do you remember? There was
I sure
store.
Do.
I'm not going to say which store it
Gucci.
Is.
Gucci.
It's called Gucci. And we'd show up. And Joe, his name was Joe.
Joe from Gucci.
He would bring a bottle of champagne. And it's like 2 o'clock in the afternoon.
Only when Mark showed up. When I went there, I'm not kidding, like security would follow me around. You know what I mean? I'm like, I'm not stealing. I swear to God, I'm not stealing.
So I bought some crazy things. I remember a vest with like some type of fake fur or something. It was crazy. And then this jacket was purchased that jacket was absolutely purchased. That is Tom Ford Gucci, though.
Yeah, that is Tom Ford for Gucci.
Actually, I take that back.
Yeah,
I like
amazing.
That. I like
it's,
that.
But the problem in that photo is not you. Look at what I'm wearing. Okay?
I think you look great.
Guys, that was a faux python romper. Python romper.
Yeah, it's very Charlie's Angels. Like
with a sparkly beaded mini skirt on top for good measure.
Yeah.
Okay? Because I couldn't decide what to wear. And somebody was like, why don't you wear both? And I was like, that's an amazing idea. I'm going to wear both. And I'm going to look amazing. And I'm going to stand next to my husband wearing a Tom Ford for Gucci purple paisley velveteen jacket. And we're gonna go to the Soap Opera Digest Awards and we're gonna win them.
And I was wearing bell bottoms there.
You sure are.
Oh, who told you told me that was appropriate?
I told you that would add an inch to your height.
Anyway, that's why we buy stuff because.
Listen, I wanna go over something with you.
Come on, bring it.
This is very exciting because I know that you are into spicy food.
I am.
You talk about how you don't think it's hot enough unless the back of your head sweats.
That's right.
Right. And they have something now. Have you heard of this? It's called the, what's it called, Gelman? The Scoville scale is the scale of how hot peppers are.
Yeah.
So like a jalapeno pepper is 2,500 to 8,000 points.
Yep.
The cayenne pepper is 30,000 to 50,000. The ghost pepper is 855,000 to 1 million points on the scale of hot. And now they have this thing called the, it's called the Pocky?
The Carolina Reaper.
The Carolina Reaper pepper.
Okay.
The Pocky company has made a deadly potato chip.
Right.
A corn chip.
Yes.
It's a corn chip. I don't know because it's in a condom. Now, anytime a potato chip is in a condom, I get nervous.
I went to a restaurant, sidebar real quick, that had the level of heat that you could order, and one of them was, are you kidding?
Right.
So I ordered, are you kidding? And the back of my head was like somebody threw a pail of water on me.
Well,
I'm not touching that because I saw something on YouTube. These girls, was that the one?
Probably, yeah.
They ate it, joking around like these YouTube star girls. Right. And then what transpired the next 6 minutes was puking and bawling.
Yeah.
Pretty much what, I mean, I heard crying and whining, kind of like Lola. Like,
right, it sounded like Lola. Be teenage girls
no,
on YouTube.
They, look it up, girls eat a hot pepper. Maybe I'm making this up, I'm not sure. Maybe it was a movie I watched, I don't know.
Maybe after
I'm very lonely. I'm very lonely.
I know, because sometimes you change the channel of our television.
Right. So what are we doing here?
From your cell phone.
What are we doing? I'm not touching that.
No, they put rubber gloves here in case we want to open it and see what it looks like.
Yeah, but don't eat it.
Don't eat it.
Yeah.
Don't eat it.
Do we want to see what it looks like?
Let's see what it looks like.
Okay. Are you going to put the rubber gloves on?
Why not?
Okay.
Be careful.
Sir, they're not going to fit you.
Good in some books.
Oh, my gosh. How did you know to do that?
I saw it on this show. It's called The Night.
His brother really is.
Yeah, no, I've seen doctors do this.
It's a Howie Mandel trick.
Boy, you are really squeezing yourself into that club. Okay.
Okay.
Go ahead. Open that.
Okay.
All right, now.
Don't breathe the air.
Okay.
So what is this? Is this a chip?
I don't know what's about to happen.
Oh, God. I don't really feel comfortable with this.
You have the gloves on. Pull it out.
Ah. Guys.
There it is.
Don't we have horror music or something we can play?
Dun, dun, dun.
Yeah, look at that. And so that's supposed to be hot? Gelman?
Yeah, it's supposed to be deadly.
Did you think that one of
Gelman,
us would
I'll give
that?
You $5
no. I'll give you no. $5.
Come on. $5 to you. Gelman, $5.
First of all, I'm insulted by your offer.
Gelman.
Secondly, no.
$7.
Look, we're each going to give you $5.
Oh, wow.
That's $10.
Yeah.
$10.
I'm moving this over here. I am intrigued, though, because it looks like a Dorito, and I love a Dorito.
Yeah, it doesn't look bad, but I'd be careful. Yeah.
Yeah. Okay. And, you know, I'm not going to touch my face.
Yeah, don't touch anything.
Don't touch anything.
This is very exciting. You're welcome, everyone. Yeah. Are you okay?
Yeah. I'm good.
Is that latex?
That's latex powder.
Oh, my God. Don't touch me if that's latex powder.
That's fine.
Okay.
All right.
Okay.
I want that to be my nickname, the Carolina Reaper. Will you call me that at home?
Done and done. Yes, you are the Carolina Reaper. Hey.
All right, are we still on the air?
Yeah, we're still on the air. I want you guys to know that today at 10:21 a.m., 10:21 Eastern Time, summer ends. Summer ends. Don't shoot the messenger. It's not my fault. Wasn't my idea. All right, we got a huge show today. From Secrets and Lies, Juliette Lewis is here.
I love her. And we have NASCAR driver Brad Keselowski.
Yes, we're going to race.
Are we gonna race him? I'm gonna win. You know I used to be a professional or a race car driver.
Yeah, I know. Mark also thought he was a professional race car driver. There's so many sports Mark thought he was professional at. There's the list is endless.
Yeah.
Are you ready? Here,
yes.
Pick up your
what is this?
Wait till you see this. Check it. Check this out. We have lightsabers now.
Yeah. Oh my gosh. Does stuff come out of it, or?
Yeah, you'll see.
Okay.
Watch, it's time for Takeoff Travel Trivia.
Okay.
Hi.
Who is that?
Hey, that's Isabel Espinoza from New Orleans. We love New Orleans so much. Will you take us home with you?
Absolutely.
Yay! Hey, on the phone is Tanya Johnson from Marysville, Washington. Why don't you take her off? Take her off. Oh, my gosh. All what right. happened
there we
to
go.
You?
That's late. That's the powder.
It's, oh, my
it's
gosh.
Fun.
Hey, Tanya, how you doing?
Doing good.
What do you do for a living in Marysville, Washington?
I actually work at home as a medical coder.
Oh.
Medical coder?
What does that mean?
Yeah. So I take, like, all the illnesses and procedures, and I turn them into codes so the insurance will pay for them.
Okay.
Oh, my gosh. That's
right.
An important job.
That is an important job.
Holy cow.
All right, listen.
Does that count for plastic surgery, too? I'm inquiring for a friend.
I have coded plastic surgery.
Okay. All right.
All right, cool.
Listen, we're going to spin the wheel, see what you're playing for, okay?
All right. What is she playing for?
Okay, here we go.
Oh.
Here we go. The Westin Ka'anapali.
Yes.
Nice.
Ocean Resort Villas in Maui. Okay.
Seven.
7 days, six nights in a one-bedroom villa includes a spa treatment per person.
Yeah. This trip is provided in part by Hotels.com. Mark Consuelos is picking up the other part. It's a prize valued at $10,400. You have 20 seconds and only one guest, Tanya. Good luck.
All right, Tanya, here we go. Kiefer Sutherland appeared on yesterday's show. In what 1986 film did Kiefer say he appeared when he was 17 years old?
Stand by Me.
That's right.
Congratulations. You and a guest will enjoy 7 days and six nights at the Westin Ka'anapali Ocean Resort and Villa in Hawaii. Located on 26 ocean acres of North Ka'anapali Beach, this AAA four-diamond resort provide spacious villa accommodations with Western amenities such as heavenly bed, whirlpool tubs, and a fully equipped kitchen. The resort also offers a full-service spa, three restaurants and bars, outdoor pools, and much more. Your prize is valued at approximately $10,400.
That looks like fun.
That was fun.
Yeah.
I want to go to Ka'anapali.
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 Ka'anapali. I pronounce it wrong every time. To the point where they're going to stop giving us that trip on our trivia wheel. Hey, Tanya, congratulations.
Thank you so much.
All right. Little known fact, Jerry O'Connell was at our house last night, by the way.
Yeah.
Yeah. Also in Stand By Me. Right. Yeah. Mm-hmm. So now you get to help make the day of a lucky member of our studio audience, Tanya, who will receive a $500 gift card from Crate and Barrel. Number between 1 and 235.
I'll go with number 1.
What? What? All right. We found him. Show with Juliette Lewis when we return. Stick around, everybody.
Still ahead on Live, NASCAR driver Brad Keselowski.
I am loving, can I just hang out with you guys?
Yeah.
Is that what we're doing?
Yes.
I love it.
Anytime you want, you are welcome to join our little club. So you were at the Friars Club last night, is that true?
Yes, we did a Martin Scorsese tribute spoke. And there's a handful of people that changed my life and mean the world to me and my creative journey, and Scorsese is one of them.
You work so well together.
I thought so.
Yeah.
I was about 17 or 18 when I did that movie, Cape Fear.
Gosh, that movie still scares
us to death.
Yes.
Okay.
Yeah.
You were amazing.
I survived. That's good.
Let me ask you a question.
Yeah.
What did De Niro's thumb taste like?
Oh, Kelly, you only knew how many times I've been asked that question.
No, but I am really curious. Do you recall?
It was flavorless, okay? We were caught up in a very intense scene.
Yeah, but you had such, I just remember thinking, where did this woman come from and why is she so talented? Because you really had the essence of this young girl who is going through high school, and you had this presence and this ability to portray so much with just your face. You know?
It was really wild because it was the first time I was working with such an incredible team and someone who liked layers and complexity. And so I wasn't that girl at that time, but everybody believed that. And that's the greatest compliment you can ask for.
You were really amazing. And it wasn't your first job. Obviously, you started out as a child actor as well, right?
It's funny because last night I told in the speech, I was like, I was ready to give up acting at 16. And then Scorsese gave me this opportunity. But I did do a few shows. I did television, and there was,
We have a little clip for you.
Oh, I can't wait.
We did a clip from you when you were on The Wonder Years.
Oh. All right, so
You play a homicide detective? Now, watching you there, that is the most straight-laced and buttoned up I've ever seen you in any of your characters. How hard was that for you?
You wouldn't imagine, because everything from the suit to the hair, it's like wearing an emotional straitjacket.
Yeah.
And I interviewed and talked to real homicide detectives, and it's a line of work. You cannot lead with your emotions.
Right.
Could you imagine if you and I came and we saw a dead body, I would just drop to the floor.
Right.
It would be a mess. So I liken her to kind of a mathematician, or she's playing chess. And anyway, I'm so excited about this season. My cast is everything. I'm so
that
proud
is,
of them.
You have the best cast. It really is. You are a great group of actors.
What can
we expect this season? What will transpire?
Will you be chewing gum in a scene?
I will not. Cornell does not chew gum.
No, okay, got it.
Sure.
For the first time, this is one of those roles people would stop me on the street last season and go, I hate you.
Right.
I mean, wow, this is awesome. I've really affected you. They said it with love, of course.
Yeah.
But this season, we'll get to see what makes her tick a little bit, mm-hmm. and her secrets and lies and her emotional core, that's sort of midway through. And then just lots of twists and turns. Brilliant cast, Terry O'Quinn, Makia Fox, and Makia Cox, sorry, I said her name wrong. And then Michael Ealy, of course.
Right.
And I'm just so excited about, I can't say anything. That's sort of your sworn.
I will say this, I love the power bun. I think it's amazing.
Thank you.
You look great that way. It's that Secrets and Lies. The season premiere airs Sunday night at 9 p.m. on ABC. Make sure you check out Juliette Lewis on Secrets and Lies.
From the Magnificent Seven, Denzel Washington. And also we'll see what happens when the Impractical Jokers.
Thanks for having me.
How's everything?
I am doing super. How are you?
We're excited that you're here because Mark also fancies himself a professional race car.
I heard.
Yes.
I heard. I'm a little worried because he's got a size 11 foot. You know, they say big right foots.
Yeah.
They go fast, right?
That's right. Did you grow up racing in your family?
I did.
Yes.
So family racers, my grandfather actually started racing when NASCAR was first started, which was in the early 50s, late 40s, and kind of passed it down to my dad, and I grew up in the entire family, and you know, I think every little boy somewhat idolizes their dad.
Yeah.
And so my dad was a race car driver, and I watched him and said, gosh, if I could do that, it would be great.
That's incredible.
Yeah, that's me and my dad. Obviously, I was a lot smaller then, and I'm wearing the shirt, and it says my first Talladega race shirt. And Talladega is a track that I didn't know then, obviously, but I've won there four times. It's been great to me.
Unbelievable.
So. Do you watch Talladega Nights before you race that race?
Shake and bake.
Shake and bake. Did you grow up, did you do go-karts? Did you kart race?
I did. I ran a little bit of go-karts, a little bit of quarter midgets, which are kind of like t-ball for racing. Yeah. That's how you kind of get started. And it was, one of the most fun times of my life, just being a kid and just getting that thrill of going fast. It's just amazing.
What's the best piece of advice your dad gave you, racing advice?
Simple. So I'm 6 foot tall now, about 165 pounds, 170 pounds. But when I was a kid, I was the little kid. You know, there was kids, you know, they get bigger in different ways, but I was always the little kid.
Right.
And my dad told me when I was first getting a car, he said, this is the thing about racing. It doesn't matter how big you are. It's how big you play. It's how big you drive. It's what you can do, what's in your head. It's your mindset. It's your mentality. None of this other stuff matters. You're just as big, if not bigger, than anyone else when you're in that car.
I have goosebumps.
I know.
So can you come over every morning and say that to me while I'm shaving?
It is. It's. So he said it to me, and my dad's not really a motivational speaker, but No, I keep that with me to this day. When you're in the race car, it doesn't matter how big you are.
Yeah.
That's awesome.
Now, there's somebody else in your family that's getting into racing. Is that right?
She fancies herself as being one, but she's working her way up to it. It's my little daughter.
Oh, my gosh.
Yeah, so she might have seen Dad do a couple victory celebrations. And so, yeah, she's ready to get behind the wheel at 16 months.
Okay.
So
it's so funny because we have a 19-year-old who refuses to drive. Okay? Yeah. And I think it's maybe that he's grown up in New York City, that he's like, I don't need to drive. I have a Metro card. But how do you encourage children to drive? Like, I don't mean obviously at three, but how do you get kids to drive when they're teenagers and they don't want to drive?
I don't think I'm going to have that problem.
Yeah, right. Okay.
I would say that, you know, the thrill of driving for me is something that it was just amazing the first time I had the opportunity. And I think getting on an open road where you don't have anything to worry about is probably the best place to get started.
Yeah.
And I'll never forget, you know, riding on the lap of my dad the first time we drove his Ford pickup truck.
Yeah.
And getting to drive it, and it was like the best day of my life.
Yeah, that's cool.
Well, all right.
So I would say, Dad,
this is going to be the second best day of your life.
Yeah. Oh,
because we're going to race each other.
We're going to race you.
Whoa.
Yeah, we're amazing. Yeah.
Are you ready for that?
No. 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 We're going to race, Brad. We're going to come back. We're going to find out who the real champion is in this section.
Enter Live's Catch the Cat. Tune in to win for the chance to win cat.
This is exciting. Brad, we wanted to make sure that you are ready for your race next weekend. So I can't tell you what's happening here. We have these battery-operated cars, and we're going to head through this course, right? And then ultimately, one of us will win all the marbles.
That's right.
So we have to go around twice, right?
Go around twice, cross the finish line.
And cross the finish line.
Size doesn't matter in racing.
That's right. And rubbing is racing.
Okay.
What?
And my nickname is Bad Brad, so look out.
All right, okay. Drivers, are you ready?
Wait, hang on. Oh, my God.
Push. Okay.
On your mark, get set, go!
Second round for the Chase at NASCAR Sprint New Hampshire Motor Speedway.
Congratulations.
This Sunday at 2 p.m. on NBCSN.
I won!
I'm glad I don't have to race against her.
Tomorrow on Live from the Magnificent Seven, Chris Pratt.
Congratulations.
Just remember, it's not a race, it's a marathon.
If you ain't first, you're last.
If you ain't first, you're last, as Ricky Bobby said. What was I going to say? I was going to say something. Oh, yes, just when I don't think I can look more like Mick Jagger, I do. Erica Sheldon brand from Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania. She's talking about the Carolina Reaper.
Yeah.
She had two drops of Carolina Reaper Prepper hot sauce at a festival this weekend, and her mouth was still burning after we got home 3 hours later. It is hot, but she still uses it in her chili.
Yes. David from North Bay, Ontario has a problem with me using the nickname Carolina Reaper. He says I must take a bite of the chip first.
Oh.
Yeah, I think you can call me coward then. I'm not taking it. Not happening.
Okay.
I watched that YouTube video.
Yeah, you saw that video. Hey, from Wayne, New Jersey, Tara Martin says, clothing. I buy clothes for the lifestyle I want, not the lifestyle I have.
Yeah.
I would say that's
that.
Pretty much 99% of all of us.
In respect to purchasing an expensive item, Lisa Ann Marie from Facebook said, wise words from my mom have helped me with my husband. Always tell him how much you saved, not much, not how much you spent.
That's so true. That is true. I did that the other day. I didn't get something, remember? And I was like, I just saved you so much money.
Yes. Yes.
Because I didn't buy something. I was pretty proud of myself. Okay, we'll take a break. We'll be right back. We're going to take a look inside your show.
If you'd like to know more about anything you see online, just log on to our website, livekelly.com.
Hey, so he's not just my co-host. He's one of the stars of Fox's drama, which is premiering tonight, Pitch. In this scene, you're discussing the future of the first woman Major League Baseball player. Take a look.
We can't send
it. I get to work with Balaban and Dan Loria. It's so amazing.
I'm really proud of you.
Thank you so much.
I love this show so much. I got a sneak peek because, I'm married to him. And I have to say, it's a fantastic show. And I'm
Thank
really
you.
Proud of you.
Thank
I'm
you.
Proud of the whole premise.
Thank you.
So don't forget to check it out tonight. It premieres tonight at 9 p.m. on Fox. And we'll be at Back to School Night. So that's very exciting for us. Thanks for being here.
Thank you for having me.
I loved having you. Yeah.
The Impractical Jokers.
Yeah, we play a joke on the Impractical Jokers. Hi. That's nice. Hey, guess what? I know. Guess what? My baby daddy really is here today. Mark Consuelos, everybody.
Do you say that a lot?
I do. I sometimes say it when Anderson's here, like as a joke. I'm like, my baby daddy. And everybody gets a big laugh. But it's actually true. You are.
I am.
Yeah. You are the father of our children.
Thank you for saying that.
Yeah, you're welcome. You're welcome. I'm so excited that you're here today. I'm so excited for tonight, for the premiere of your new show.
I'm so excited.
Yeah.
I've been lucky enough to do some really cool projects over the past few years.
Yeah.
And each one I say, this is my favorite one. This is my favorite one. I kind of think this is my favorite one.
It's my favorite one.
It's my favorite
one.
It's a show called Pitch. It's written by Dan Fogelman and Rick Singer. It's about the first female Major League Baseball player.
Yeah.
Which is
a pitcher.
Amazing.
Yeah.
MLB is our partner. Major League Baseball is our partner in the show, which is fantastic. So we get to wear all the cool logos. I play the GM, which is I play an ex-ball player because now I'm at the age where I play ex-athletes.
Right. Remember when we first met and you used to play athletes?
I know. Yeah, I used to play athletes.
Now he plays ex-athletes.
Now I play, and I'm really psyched about that because I get to wear cool suits and I don't have to wear like the goofy baseball uniform because after a certain age, guys shouldn't wear uniforms.
Right. Okay, good.
You know what I mean?
Yeah. Did you talk to MLB about
that? Well, no, because the GM wears a suit.
You know, I was telling people that you are on a show with the first female pitcher in the NBA. And people were like, okay. Because that's basketball.
That is basketball.
But I didn't understand, you know, I didn't get it. Now I get it.
But the,
get it now.
You saw the pilot. It's directed by the fantastic Paris Barclay. He's amazing.
So good.
Kevin Falls is our showrunner. The cast, Allie Larder, Jersey Girl.
Yeah. Oh my gosh, this girl, I love her so
Mark
much.
Mark Paul Gosselaar, Mo McCray, Tim Joe, Megan Holder.
Tell the audience, because you
last
had,
night?
No, you had all of these funny.
How about my Freudian slip last night?
Oh, yeah. Oh, my God.
But the pitcher is played by this wonderful actress named Kylie Bunbury. She's amazing.
She's amazing.
And they're asking me about her, and I'm like, and I said last night.
This is what he says out loud in front of me.
I mean, she's amazing. You can't keep your hands off of her. And I meant to say, you can't keep your eyes off of her.
But he said hands.
I said that out loud.
I was like, well, you better try. It was the funniest thing ever. No, I was going to say that you and how they, wherever you guys go, wherever the cast goes, they have Mark Paul Gosselaar, and now they've changed Mark's name to Mark Paul Consuelos. They just have added a Paul to your name.
We go to a press event, and they'll give us a little placard, and sometimes he's Mark Paul Consuelos, or I'm typically Mark Paul Gosselaar.
You're Mark Paul.
I like it. I like a middle name.
I like it too.
I like it. Are you glad to have me home? I've been gone for a few weeks.
It's an adjustment. I'm not going to lie. I was very excited to see you when you came home yesterday. That was a nice surprise.
It was.
That was a nice surprise.
I did surprise you when I came home.
You did. Surprise.
I came home. I'm here.
Daddy's home.
I got to tell you, I like living in Los Angeles a little bit.
Okay, is there something you want to announce?
No. It's really nice. I think a cloud one day.
In all the time you've been gone?
In the whole summer that I've been gone.
Wow.
It's pretty cool.
Yeah. It's pretty cool having you gone, I have to say.
Tell me about it.
We're doing all sorts of things. Like, the kids have moved into our room.
Right.
So I don't know if you know that. We now are all living in our bed.
Yes, like carnival people.
Like carnival people.
Yeah.
Right. And
nothing against carnival people.
Yeah, no. And we sometimes we eat in the bed. Like, we'll have snacks on movie night.
That's horrible.
Yeah, I know. We're breaking all sorts of rules.
And?
We are breaking your rules like crazy.
Are you, like, touching things? He said, don't touch that. I can touch that.
Oh,
I can eat.
The kids have friends over every day.
Good.
They're playing playing video games. It's really crazy. It's like we're breaking.
I don't let the kids not have. Oh, the kids don't want to come over because
they don't want to come over
because the mean dad's there.
Yeah, mean dad. Yeah. means your dad makes us pick up our toys afterwards. You know, that kind of stuff. So we have playdates constantly now.
Awesome.
It's like.
Well, I have playdates too, constantly.
I know.
No, I'm by myself. I walk around lonely. I got locked out of the house the other day.
In his underpants. It's an amazing story.
No, I was dressed and.
He FaceTimed me.
I'm like, all right, so I'm locked out. The wind closed. I was on this little balcony. The door shut. It closed. And I didn't know what to do. And I called Uber.
That makes perfect sense.
I'm just going to, like, call Uber because they'll figure it out. Like, what are they going to do? Bring me my keys? I got Uber X. Come on, let's have a party.
No, but how did you wind up getting in?
I was so embarrassed. I called the it's a rental, so the person who's managing the rental property, I called and they came and then I did it again. Did it twice. I mean, I'm pretty useless by myself.
I know.
Pretty useless. So you guys are having, like, a party, and I'm, like,
you're,
you know,
suffering.
I'm
so
suffering.
Much.
I'm suffering.
In your house with your one cloud. I do miss you terribly.
Oh,
you should
thank
know that.
You.
I do. Yeah. I put up a good front. But I do miss you terribly.
Yeah.
I like
it's not what I hear, but it's
no,
fine.
I forget how useful you are in my life for so many reasons.
Tell me.
I don't just mean, like, I love you and I enjoy our time together.
Uh-huh.
There's no lights in the house work. I cannot get the temperature.
That's me. I'm turning stuff off.
He does.
I turn stuff off, so you'll miss me.
He has a thing on his phone.
An app?
An app on his phone that allows him to control me from afar. So all of a sudden, I will wake up in the middle of the night, and I'm like, it's
well, because
freezing
I'm thinking,
in
you know
here.
What, 76... I'm not there, but that's a little too humid for me. I need to turn it down, even though I just want to make sure that it's that the house is
so I'm well preserved.
Well preserved.
Right. But I do miss you, but I'm happy to see you.
Thank you. Hey, traffic is insane in the city. The UN's in town.
The UN is in town.
Okay.
I got out of the car yesterday. We were pointing the wrong direction. We couldn't make a left to head back uptown. I said to my driver, I said, you know what? Go with God. I'll see you later. I was 30 blocks away. I walked home.
Yeah.
It's
excuse
it's,
me, I picked you up.
That's
but
true.
That's okay. You didn't walk home. I was like, okay, you're leaving out a part of the story. I picked you up on the way home.
Oh, are we now the accuracy police here on, okay, all right. Okay. I'm going to embellish this funny story.
We can
But now, let's be the accuracy police. I heard you didn't shave your legs yesterday, and you absolutely shaved your legs.
I heard about that.
People are texting me, she didn't shave her legs. Guess what? They were very shaved at 5:30 in the morning when I came home.
I know, because I got up and shaved them when I heard you were coming home.
Okay.
A little birdie told me you got on an earlier flight.
The birdie was me. Let's be accurate. Let's be accurate. The birdie was me.
You don't want
Let's
me
keep
to...
going. Okay. Let's keep going.
Do you want me to tell them about what else you do with
Bring
that phone?
Bring it on. Bring it on. No.
Okay, because I can... He does things with the phone that aren't right and
Listen,
should not be discussed.
I want to talk to you about something.
Okay.
There's the science of why we buy clothes that we never wear.
Oh, my gosh.
I want to talk to you about that because, you know...
I'm the queen
of that. You will buy something, and then you'll talk about how, okay, it's X amount, which is never too expensive because you're very sensible. But you'll say, just think about it. If I wear it 150 times, it's only going to be
$3. Yeah. That is, if I buy a pricey item... Because we came from actor backgrounds together, so we've always been very mindful of every job could be your last job, right? So we plan for the future that way.
Yeah.
And so when I would buy something expensive, he's like, "Well, that's really expensive," and I'm like, "Yeah, but I've worn it 700 times. So price per wear, it's now paying me to wear it."
So people will ignore a major flaw if it's on sale.
Yes, that's true. I've done that.
Yeah, like I won't. I mean,
I will ignore a lipstick stain because it's 97%.
So that's one. We purchase for fantasy, not reality. So when we purchase stuff, we visualize ourselves wearing it. Right? I'm going to look amazing in that. And then it's not. The reality is, I'm still 5'8", and it's not going to look good on me. You know what I mean?
5'9".
Wait, 5'9", by the way. Let's be accurate.
Excuse me.
I just cut an inch off myself.
I would say you added an inch to yourself.
I need tape measure. We're going to get a tape measure during commercial break.
Oh, these men.
During commercial break.
Always adding inches here and there. Yes. We know about your shoe size. We know.
Third,
we know.
Size 11. Third.
Know.
Big hands.
Third
thing is we love the item too much. Like, you'll buy something, but you won't wear it because you love it.
I'm too afraid to wear it because I love it so much.
I've heard that come out of your mouth. You've actually said that out loud.
He's like, why don't you wear that new jacket? I'm like, I could never wear this. I love it so much. This is just a display.
We go shopping while tipsy. That's another reason. And do you remember?
Yes.
Do you remember? There was
I sure
store.
Do.
I'm not going to say which store it
Gucci.
Is.
Gucci.
It's called Gucci. And we'd show up. And his name was Joe.
Joe from Gucci.
He would bring a bottle of champagne. And it's like 2:00 in the afternoon.
Only when Mark showed up. When I went there, I'm not kidding, like security would follow me around. You know what I mean? I'm like, I'm not stealing. I swear to God, I'm not stealing.
So I bought some crazy things. I remember a vest with some type of fake fur or something. It was crazy. And then this jacket was purchased That jacket was absolutely purchased. That is Tom Ford Gucci, though.
Yeah, that is Tom Ford for Gucci.
Actually, I take that back.
Yeah, you
I like
amazing.
That. I like
it's,
that.
What the problem in that photo is not you. Look at what I'm wearing. Okay?
I think you look great.
Guys, that was a faux python romper. Python romper.
Yeah, it's very Charlie's Angels.
With a sparkly beaded mini skirt on top for good measure.
Yeah.
Okay? Because I couldn't decide what to wear. And somebody was like, why don't you wear both? And I was like, that's an amazing idea. I'm going to wear both. And I'm going to look amazing. And I'm going to stand next to my husband wearing a Tom Ford for Gucci purple paisley velveteen jacket. And we're going to go to the Soap Opera Digest Awards, and we're going to win them.
And I was wearing bell bottoms there.
You sure are.
Oh, who told you told me that was appropriate?
I told you that would add an inch to your height.
Anyway, that's why we buy stuff, because...
Listen, I want to go over something with you.
Come on, bring it.
This is very exciting, because I know that you are into spicy food.
I am.
You talk about how you don't think it's hot enough unless the back of your head sweats.
That's right.
Right. And they have something now. Have you heard of this? It's called the... what's it called, Gelman? The Scoville scale is the scale of how hot peppers are.
Yeah.
So like a jalapeno pepper is 2,500 to 8,000 points.
Yep.
The cayenne pepper is 30,000 to 50,000. The ghost pepper is 855,000 to 1 million points on the scale of hot. And now they have this thing called the... it's called the Pocky?
The Carolina Reaper.
The Carolina Reaper pepper.
Okay.
The Pocky company has made a deadly potato chip.
Right.
A corn chip.
Yes.
It's a corn chip. I don't know, because it's in a condom. Now, anytime a potato chip is in a condom, I get nervous.
I went to a restaurant, sidebar real quick, that had the level of heat that you could order, and one of them was, are you kidding?
Right.
So I ordered, are you kidding? And the back of my head
was
like somebody threw a pail of water on me.
Well,
I'm not touching that, because I saw something on YouTube. These girls, was that the one?
Probably, yeah.
They ate it, joking around like these YouTube star girls. Right. And then what transpired the next 6 minutes was puking and bawling.
Yeah. Yeah.
Pretty much I heard crying and whining, kind of like Lola. Like,
right. It sounded like just Lola, be teenage girls
no.
on YouTube.
They, look it up, girls eat a hot pepper. Maybe I'm making this up, I'm not sure. Maybe it was a movie I watched, I don't know.
Maybe after
I'm very lonely.
I know, because sometimes you change the channel of our television.
Right. So what are we doing here?
From your cell phone.
What are we doing? I'm not touching that.
No, they put rubber gloves here in case we want to open it and see what it looks like.
Yeah, but don't eat it.
Don't eat it.
Yeah. Don't eat it.
Do we want to see what it looks
like? Let's see what it looks like.
Okay. Are you going to put the rubber gloves on?
Why not?
Okay.
Be careful.
They're not going to fit you.
Good in some blood.
Oh, my gosh. How did you know to do that?
I saw it on this show. It's called The Night...
His brother really is.
Yeah, no, I've seen doctors do this.
It's a Howie Mandel trick.
Boy, you are really squeezing yourself into that glove. Okay.
Okay.
Go ahead. Open that.
Okay.
All right, now...
Don't breathe the air.
Okay.
So what is this? Is this a chip?
I don't know what's about to happen.
Oh, God. I don't really feel comfortable about this.
You have the gloves on. Pull it out.
Ah.
Guys.
There it is.
Don't we have horror music or something we can play?
Dun, dun, dun.
Yeah, look at that. And so that's supposed to be hot?
Yeah.
Gelman?
Yeah, it's supposed to be deadly.
Did you think that one of
Gelman,
us would
I'll give
that?
You $5
no. I'll give you $5.
Come on. $5 to you. Gelman, $5.
First of all, I'm insulted by your offer. Secondly, no.
$7. Look, we're each going to give you $5.
Oh, wow.
That's $10.
Yeah.
$10.
I'm moving this over here. I am intrigued, though, because it looks like a Dorito, and I love a Dorito.
Yeah, it doesn't look bad, but I'd be careful. Yeah.
Yeah. Okay. And, you know, I'm not going to touch my face.
Yeah, don't touch anything.
Don't touch anything.
This is very exciting. You're welcome, everyone. Yeah. Are you okay?
Yeah. I'm good.
Is that latex?
That's latex powder.
don't touch me if that's latex powder.
That's fine.
Okay.
All right.
Okay.
I want that to be my nickname, the Carolina Reaper. Will you call me that at home?
Done and done. Yes, you are the Carolina Reaper. Hey.
All right, are we still on the air?
Yeah, we're still on the air. I want you guys to know that today at 10:21 a.m. Eastern time, summer ends. Summer ends. Don't shoot the messenger. It's not my fault. It wasn't my idea. All right, we got a huge show today. From Secrets and Lies, Juliette Lewis is here.
I love her.
I love her.
And we have NASCAR driver Brad Keselowski.
Yes, we're going to race him.
Are we going to race him?
I'm gonna win.
You know, I used to be a professional or a race car driver.
Yeah, I know. Mark also thought he was a professional race car driver. There's so many sports Mark thought he was professional at. There's the list is endless.
Yeah.
Are you ready? Here,
yes.
Pick up your.
What is this?
Wait till you see this. Check it. Check this out. We have lightsabers now.
Yeah. Oh my gosh. Does stuff come out of it or?
Yeah, you'll see.
Okay.
Watch. It's time for Takeoff Travel Trivia.
Okay. Hi.
I got it.
Who is that?
Hey, that's Isabel Espinoza from New Orleans. We love New Orleans so much. Will you take us home with you?
Absolutely.
Yay! Hey, on the phone is Tanya Johnson from Marysville, Washington. Why don't you take her off? Oh my gosh, all right. What happened to you?
That's late. That's the powder.
Oh my gosh.
Fun.
Hey, Tanya, how you doing?
Doing good.
What do you do for a living in Marysville, Washington?
I actually work at home as a medical coder.
Oh. Medical coder?
What does that mean?
Yeah. So I take like all the illnesses and procedures and I turn them into codes so the insurance will pay for them.
Okay.
Oh my gosh. That's an important job.
That is an important job.
Holy cow.
All right, listen.
Does that count for plastic surgery, too? I'm inquiring for a friend.
I have coded plastic surgery.
Okay. All right.
All right, cool.
Listen, we're going to spin the wheel, see what you're playing for, okay?
What is she playing for?
Okay, here we go.
Oh.
Here we go. The Westin Ka'anapali.
Yes. Nice.
Ocean Resort Villas in Maui. Okay.
7 days, 6 nights in a one-bedroom villa includes a spa treatment per person.
Yeah. This trip is provided in part by Hotels.com. Mark Consuelos is picking up the other part. It's a prize valued at $10,400. You have 20 seconds and only one guess, Tanya. Good luck.
All right, Tanya, here we go. Kiefer Sutherland appeared on yesterday's show. In what 1986 film did Kiefer say he appeared when he was 17 years old?
Stand by Me.
That's right.
Congratulations. You and a guest will enjoy 7 days and 6 nights at the Westin Ka'anapali Ocean Resort and Villa in Hawaii. Located on 26 ocean acres of North Ka'anapali Beach, this AAA four-diamond resort provides spacious villa accommodations with Westin amenities such as heavenly bed, whirlpool tubs, and a fully equipped kitchen. The resort also offers a full-service spa, 3 restaurants and bars, outdoor pools, and much more. Your prize is valued at approximately $10,400.
That was like fun.
That was fun.
Yeah.
I want to go to Ka'anapali.
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 I pronounce it wrong every time. To the point where they're going to stop giving us that trip on our trivia wheel. Hey, Tanya, congratulations.
Thank you so much.
All right. Little known fact, Jerry O'Connell was at our house last night, by the way.
Yeah.
Yeah. Also in Stand By Me. Right. Yeah. Mm-hmm. So now you get to help make the day of a lucky member of our studio audience, Tanya, who will receive a $500 gift card from Crate and Barrel. Pick a number between 1 and 235.
I'll go with number 1.
What? What? All right. You found him. with Juliette Lewis when we return. Stick around, everybody.
Still ahead on Live, NASCAR driver Brad Keselowski.
I am loving, can I just hang out with you guys?
Yeah.
We got what we're doing.
Yes.
I love it.
Anytime you want, you are welcome to join our little club. So you were at the Friars Club last night, is that true?
Yes, we did a Martin Scorsese tribute spoke. And there's a handful of people that changed my life and mean the world to me and my creative journey, and Scorsese is one of them.
You work so well together.
I thought so.
Yeah.
I was about 17 or 18 when I did that movie, Cape Fear.
Gosh, that movie still scares
us to death.
Yes.
Okay.
Yeah.
You were amazing.
I survived. That's good.
Let me ask you a question.
Yeah.
What did De Niro's thumb taste like?
Oh, Kelly, you only knew how many times I've been asked that question.
No, but I am really curious. Do you recall?
It was flavorless, okay? We were caught up in a very intense scene.
Yeah. But you had such... I just remember thinking, where did this woman come from, and why is she so talented? Because you really had the essence of this young girl who is going through high school, and you had this presence and this ability to portray so much with just your face. You know?
It was really wild because it was the first time I was working with such an incredible team and someone who liked layers and complexity. And so I wasn't that girl at that time, but everybody believed that. And that's the greatest compliment you can ask for.
You were really amazing. And it wasn't your first job. Obviously, you started out as a child actor as well, right?
It's funny because last night I told in this speech, I was like, I was ready to give up acting at 16. And then Scorsese gave me this opportunity. But I did do a few shows. I did television, and there was,
We have a little clip for you.
Oh, I can't wait.
We did a clip from you when you were on The Wonder Years.
Wow. All right, so you play a homicide detective. Now, watching you there, that is the most straight-laced and buttoned up I've ever seen you in any of your characters. How hard was that for you?
You wouldn't imagine, because everything from the suit to the hair, it's like wearing an emotional straitjacket.
Yeah.
And I interviewed and talked to real homicide detectives, and it's a line of work. You cannot lead with your emotions.
Right.
Could you imagine if you and I came and we saw a dead body, I would just drop to the floor.
Right. Right.
A mess. So I liken her to kind of a mathematician, or she's playing chess. And anyway, I'm so excited about this season. My cast is everything. I'm so proud of them.
You have the best cast. It really is. You are a great group of actors.
What can we
expect this season? What will transpire?
Will you be chewing gum in a scene?
I will not. Cornell does not chew gum.
No. Okay, got it.
Sure.
For the first time, this is one of those roles people would stop me on the street last season and go, I hate you.
Right.
I mean, wow, this is awesome. I've really affected you. They said it with love, of course.
Yeah.
But this season, we'll get to see what makes her tick a little bit, and her secrets and lies, and her emotional core, that's sort of midway through. And then just lots of twists and turns. Brilliant cast, Terry O'Quinn, Makia Fox. And Makia Cox, sorry, I said her name wrong. And then Michael Ealy, of course.
Right.
And I'm just so excited about, I can't say anything. Yeah. They're sort of your sworn to.
I know.
Yeah.
I will say this, I love the power bun. I think it's amazing.
Thank you.
You look great that way. It's got Secrets and Lies. The season premiere airs Sunday night at 9 p.m. on ABC. Make sure you check out Juliette Lewis.
Magnificent Seven, Denzel Washington. And also, we'll see what happens when the Impractical Jokers.
Hi, how are you? Nice to see you.
Thanks for having me.
How's everything?
I am doing super. How are you?
We're excited that you're here because Mark also fancies himself a professional race car.
I heard.
Yes.
I heard. I'm a little worried because he's got a size 11 foot. And, you know, they say big right foot.
Yeah.
They go fast, right?
That's right.
That's right.
Did you grow up racing in your family?
I did. Yes.
Family of racers,
yes.
Right?
Yes. So family racers, my grandfather actually started racing and when NASCAR was first started, which was in the early 50s, late 40s, and kind of passed it down to my dad. And I grew up in the entire family. And, you know, I think every little boy somewhat idolizes their dad.
Yeah.
And so my dad was a race car driver, and I watched him and said, gosh, if I could do that, it would be great.
That's incredible.
Yeah, that's me and my dad. Obviously, I was a lot smaller then. And I'm wearing the shirt, and it says my first Talladega race shirt. And Talladega is a track that I didn't know then, obviously, but I've won there four times. It's been great to me.
Unbelievable.
So. Do you watch Talladega Nights before you race that race?
Shake and bake.
Shake and bake. Did you grow up, did you do go-karts? Did you kart race?
I did. I ran a little bit of go-karts, a little bit of quarter midgets, which are kind of like T-ball for racing. Yeah. That's how you kind of get started. And it was, you know, one of the most fun times of my life, just being a kid and just getting that thrill of going fast. It's just amazing.
What's the best piece of advice your dad gave you, racing advice?
Simple. So I'm 6 foot tall now, about 165 pounds, 170 pounds. But when I was a kid, I was the little kid. You know, there was kids, you know, they get bigger in different ways, but I was always the little kid.
Right.
And my dad told me when I was first getting a car, he said, this is the thing about racing. It doesn't matter how big you are. It's how big you play. It's how big you drive. It's what you can do, what's in your head. It's your mindset. It's your mentality. None of this other stuff matters. You're just as big, if not bigger, than anyone else when you're in that car.
I have goosebumps.
I know.
So can you come over every morning and say that to me while I'm shaving?
It is. So he said it to me. My dad's not really a motivational speaker, but I keep that with me to this day. When you're in the race car, it doesn't matter how big you are.
Yeah.
That's awesome.
Now, there's somebody else in your family that's getting into racing. Is that right?
She fancies herself as being one, but she's working her way up to it. It's my little daughter.
Oh, my gosh.
Yeah, so she might have seen Dad do a couple victory celebrations. And she's ready to get behind the wheel at 16 months.
Okay.
So
it's so funny because we have a 19-year-old who refuses to drive. Okay? Yeah. And I think it's maybe that he's grown up in New York City, that he's like, I don't need to drive. I have a Metro card. But how do you encourage children to drive? Like, I don't mean obviously at three, but how do you get kids to drive when they're teenagers and they don't want to drive?
I don't think I'm going to have that problem.
Yeah, right. Okay.
I would say that, you know, the thrill of driving for me is something that it was just amazing the first time I had the opportunity. And I think getting on an open road where you don't have anything to worry about is probably the best place to get started.
Yeah.
And I'll never forget, you know, riding on the lap of my dad the first time we drove his Ford pickup truck and getting to drive it. And it was like the best day of my life.
Yeah, that's cool.
Well, all right.
So I would say, Dad,
this is going to be the second best day of your life.
Yeah. Oh,
because we're going to race each other.
We're going to race you.
Whoa.
Yeah, we're amazing. Yeah. Yeah.
Are you ready for that?
No. We're going to race, Brad. We're going to come back. We're going to find out who the real champion is in this section.
Enter Live's Catch the Cat. Tune in to win for the chance to win.
This is exciting. Brad, we wanted to make sure that you are ready for your race next weekend. So I can't tell you what's happening here. We have these battery-operated cars, and we're going to head through this course, right? And then ultimately, one of us will win all the marbles.
That's right.
So we have to go around twice, right?
Go around twice, cross the finish line.
And cross the finish line.
Size doesn't matter in racing.
That's right. And rubbing is racing.
Okay.
What?
And my nickname is Bad Brad, so look out.
All right,
okay.
Drivers, are you ready?
Well, hang on. Oh, my God.
Push.
On your mark, get set, go!